Hey, aloha my internet family. How are you? Welcome back to Practical Printing. Don't have a lot of new stuff for you this week, so I thought I would just give you a quick recap on projects that we have in the works, status of some things, and where some things are headed. So, first off, as you can see behind me, the mess and mass of the garage, that is a big one that's been going on. That's obviously not relevant to the channel. But the reorganization of the garage is hopefully going to allow me some more space to tinker outside of the confines of the house more. I know you've seen it as a backdrop quite a bit in some of the videos, and hopefully getting this cleaned up and organized a little bit better will allow me a little bit more permanent setup in here. So aside from that, moving into the house, as you can see that we still haven't gotten much done on the updates to Ozzy, formerly known as AG Max. Last we showed him to you, he was in the process of getting a B3i Pico hybrid hot end upgrade, as well as a complete rework of the X and the Y axis updates. Just haven't had a lot of time to work on it. Nor as we scroll past it, you can see Jank Williams Jr. is still sitting there in pieces, and I haven't had any development time to work on it or progress it further. And as you can see, the IKEA table is still empty. That is because the DI3, the Wanhao DI3, or the Monoprice Maker Select, whichever we want to call it this week, is still actually out in the garage for testing as we have been doing upgrades on it. So, as we go over to the DI3 here, you can see some of the updates that we've been working on it have included the Z-Brace, the fancy style, turnbuckle style Z-Brace kit from RepRap Champions. You can also see the Y-Plate down here, which is an all aluminum Y-Plate. We streamed the install of both of those a few weeks ago, and we've also streamed the install of the Cohesion 3D Mini smoothie-based control board into the box. There's been a few other updates to that that I'll highlight in a future video, and there's going to be some other updates to come to the DI3 as well, including putting assisted bed leveling on it with a BL Touch, and eventually it's going to get a Titan Aero. Lastly, I'm going to head back over to this guy, who you might recognize from Dustin, the Japman's videos, as the Blox Zero that used to be on the shelf behind his head. He did his reviews, finished up with the printer, and offered it up to me if I wanted to play with it. It was a pre-production unit, so there's some things that are a little bit different than the final version that got shipped and sold. And I thought I could have a good time trying to do some tweaks with this. One of the things I was looking at doing is embedding a Pi Zero into it so that it could have embedded Octoprint control, as well as trying to finish up at the Y-axis and try to make it a little bit more rigid so that it doesn't slide, and maybe a couple of other generic things. So that's it. That's where we are at. There's some other reviews and videos in the pipeline, but that's where we are at today. It's just been a crazy busy summer. All right, so I will leave you with that. I hope you are having a great weekend. Aloha, and we'll see you next time on Practical Printing.